Welcome to Be Inspired. How are you, Pastor Daniel?
In the faith, Bishop. Good evening.
Good evening, and here we are ready to bless your life. In a few moments, we're going to be seeking the Holy Spirit. Don't forget, every Wednesday, we do that in church, but also we do here on libertyradio.co.uk. And many of you have been joining us before going to bed. You are seeking God with us, meditating on the Word, and I'm sure it's been profitable. Well, it has been for me, Pastor Daniel.
Definitely.
Meditating on the Word, isn't it?
Yes.
It has been blessing our lives. And actually, this is what God tells us to do. He told Joshua to do it, but where is Joshua today? He's That's no right. longer here, so we can replace the name Joshua and put our names there. And indeed, read the Word for ourselves, right?
Definitely, Bishop. This teaching that God, you know, he instructed Joshua to do, we apply it today, and we see how the Word of God is food for our soul,
yes.
for our spirit. Just like we need the physical, you know, sustenance, the Word of God has been this for us.
And Pastor Daniel, many people have been neglecting their Bible meditation. They have been neglecting their Bibles. And people are suffering consequences, terrible consequences. Just like if I neglect food, okay, I can go without food for 1 day, 2 days. Well, myself, 2 days, I think I'm going to have a lot of, you know, negative consequences already. But some people can go without food for a couple of days. But as we all know, we cannot keep going like this more than a week, 2 weeks. Our bodies will die. And the same applies to our spiritual bodies. As we have mentioned before, I believe we spoke about this, we are three in one, remember?
Yes.
Just like God is three in one, we are body, soul, and spirit. In the same way our physical bodies need vitamins and nourishment, so does our spiritual bodies. And here is the multivitamin.
Yes.
Right? The Word of God is what gives us everything we need to keep our communion with Him strong, our spiritual life strong, our spirit strong. And eventually, as we know, once we are strong, we overcome battles, tribulations, temptations. But Pastor Daniel, as we have been seeing there, once people neglect this vitamin, this food that is vital, how many have fallen, isn't it?
Definitely.
Once people do it, how many fall into temptation? And it may be irreparable, as you have noticed. Some people never again were the same. Unfortunately, many souls were lost, and it was nobody's fault. It was the person's lack of diligence towards his or her communion with God. Eh?
Definitely, Bishop, because in the Word of God, we find God's instructions for our daily needs. We find strength. We find guidance in decision-making that we all have to go through every single day. So when the person lacks that you know, that relationship, that intimacy with God in seeking in the Word of God, so they spend their days, you know, being attacked by the devil, temptations, negative thoughts, all sorts of things that come against them. And no wonder at the end of the, you know, after some time, they're not able to resist. They're not able to withstand everything because of the lack of the Word of God in them. And obviously the lack of the knowledge and the lack of the knowing God's will, it results also in not, you know, having the wrong decisions, the wrong actions come out of it.
When you're not okay spiritually, when your communion with God is not blessed, let me put this way, it's not strong, you make a lot of bad decisions. Because we tend to act more moved by our feelings than by our intelligence. Notice this, Pastor Daniel. The majority of the people who have fallen into temptation, who have drawn back, given up, they acted impulsively, right? Acted by emotion. Later on, they regretted, but there was nothing else they could do. And unfortunately, this is what has been happening. Well, we're going to be talking about strengthening our spirits today. More precisely, we're going to be speaking about how to meditate on the Word of God. Prepare yourselves there. Prepare your Bibles. We're going to be showing you a set of slides there as well for you to understand how you can meditate on the Word. And this was a direction that God gave to Joshua. And this is a direction that God gives to you and me, to all of us. We have to meditate. And not only when it's convenient or when we remember It's day and night. I can even say to you, in the same way you eat every day, you set time, you know, an important time aside for you to have your lunch, have your dinner. Spiritually, you have to do the same as well. You must set time. You must put some time aside. Make time available. Some people say, I'm too busy. No, you are not. You cannot say you are too busy when it comes to meditating on the Word. You can be busy for anything else, but not for your Bible meditation. So in the same way you eat every day, you have to meditate on the Word every day as well. We're going to be giving you tips today so you can extract vital lessons from the Bible, and you can extract also important directions for your life. Because Pastor Danny, when we meditate on the Word, God speaks to us directly. Sometimes we'll say, why isn't God speaking to me? Why isn't God directing my life? Well, why are you not opening the Bible? Do you want to hear God's voice? Do you want Him to speak to you? Open the Bible, right?
That's right.
And they will indeed receive vital directions for all the areas of their lives. We're going to show you a testimony now. Let's now watch one more testimony. Someone who was blessed. She has been coming to church and God worked in her life. And for sure, you can become the next testimony. And during this testimony, please share the link, libertyradio.co.uk, with more people. Let's invite more people to join us. Don't forget, we're going to be seeking the Holy Spirit today. Yes, let's do it together in a few moments. And also, we're going to be giving you tips on how to meditate on the Word of God. So let's share the link, libertyradio.co.uk now. And in case you're not here on the live chat, why not type in here your testimony? Eh? Drop some lines here, briefly. Let us know what has happened recently. And don't forget, you who have a testimony, send it to this email address. Pastor Daniel, let them know the email address there for them to send the testimony. You can record using your phone, 2-3 minutes. Talk about the before and the after. Let's
That's
go.
Right. You can send your testimony at mytestimony@uckg.org. That's mytestimony@uckg.org. You can send us your testimony, or you can also send your testimony via WhatsApp at the number at 020-7686-6000.
This is it. Very convenient, isn't it?
Yes, Bishop.
People can send direct to our WhatsApp chat. You can send your video there talking about your before and your after, especially you who have received the Holy Spirit. Let us know, you who have been blessed, your family, your health, finances. Let us know. Let's rejoice here together. And let's play your testimony here. Yes, let's show people what God is doing, just like we are playing her testimony today, and she's going to inspire many people as well. Let's watch together.
Be inspired on Liberty Radio.
When I first came to the UCKG, I was very lonely, and I had sadness inside of me. I had suicidal thoughts. Even though I had apparently a perfect life, inside of me, I was very sad and depressed. I used to think of suicide all the time. I used to hate my parents. I had so much anger inside of me, in a level that I used to think of ways of how am I going to get rid of my parents, but with bad thoughts always. I couldn't sleep, I couldn't eat, I had loads of problems that my mom, she didn't know what to do. She went to a situation that she couldn't find a solution for my problems. She tried so many things. We tried to take pills to sleep. We tried to go to doctors. We tried to find solutions for my situation, because no one understood why I had so many anger inside of me. So one day, my mom decided to bring me to the church, to the UCKG Help Center, to find help. And when she came to the UCKG Help Center, one of the pastors, they prayed for me, and I started to see changes in my life. So as I came to the church, I started to read the Bible, to know what Jesus was about, what God was, and what God could do about my life, could do in my life. And I decided to make a challenge and to change everything that was going on in my life. Using the faith, I started to use my faith, and I was cured. So the first thing that God took it away from me was the anger. So that anger that I had for my parents, for my life, I wanted to kill myself. God changed that and replaced with peace and happiness. I didn't speak with my father for many, many years. But when I came to the church, I realized that all of the hatred, all of the anger wasn't doing me well. So God showed me through the faith that I could be happy and I could love my parents. So I learned through faith to learn to love my parents, to love my father. Now we have like a healthy relationship. I speak to my parents every single day, even though they don't live in the same country, but we always in touch. I always pray for my parents. So the sadness and the anger, the hatred that I had inside of me, God changed it to peace, to love, to happiness. So all of that sad life that I had before, as soon as I came to the UCKG Help Center, my life was completely changed. I completely changed my thoughts. So now I can sleep. I sleep every night. I have a healthy life. I don't have mental issues. I don't have depression. I don't have suicide thoughts. Everything, all the bad things, all the darkness that was inside of me has been replaced for light, for peace, for love, for happiness, and all of that. So the UCKG guided me in. Changed my life completely.
Be Inspired on Liberty Radio.
Welcome back to Be Inspired. And yes, you'll be the next testimony. What God did in her life, He will do in your life. All you have to do is to follow the directions that we are giving to you, the directions that God gave to us, gave to people in the past.
Yes, Bishop.
We are taking their names out of the line there, and we are putting our names.
That's right.
We are the Joshuas of the 21st century, Pastor Daniel.
Definitely. We see that this testimony is proof that when we apply what God, He teaches us, and what she learned in the church, today you see the results.
See, she's a Joshuana.
That's right.
Let's say, isn't it? If yes, I can do that.
Joshuana. She became like Joshua. She took the place of Joshua, because before she wanted to die, she was suicidal, depressed. And today she has reasons to live and share her testimony with other people.
Yeah, amazing testimony. And in Jesus' name, we're going to have many more testimonies like that one, for sure. It's amazing to see when God restores lives, isn't it, Pastor Daniel?
Yes.
Not only when He gives a blessing. And as we all know, the devil cannot change lives.
No.
You know that the devil can pretend to be good. He can do many things, pretending that he is God. But changing one's life, only one can change one's life. And He is our God.
That's right, Bishop. The author of life. He's the only one that can change the person from the inside to the outside.
Definitely. So today we are talking about a very, 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 Pastor Daniel, I don't know how many very. Varies I'm going to put there, important subject. How to meditate, as you can see there on our slide, how to meditate on the Word of God. That was an instruction that God gave to Joshua. In Joshua chapter 1, let's have a look there. If you have the Bishop's Bible there with you, and make sure you have this treasure. Yes, this is the treasure where we're going to extract the new things, new revelations. Yes, the old principles as well that have been given to us many years ago, and we still have to practice. We have to keep reminding ourselves. We have to keep going to them, isn't it, Pastor Daniel?
That's right.
Over and over again. So this is the Bishop's Bible, as it says there, with personal commentary by Bishop Edir Macedo. Have a look on the slide there, Pastor Daniel. Let them know, please, how they can acquire this Bible. Yes, in church, but also they can go online. Eh?
Definitely. This Bible is available at christianbooks-plus.com. Visit the website and you'll find there the link, and you'll be able to acquire your Bible as well. And those of you who have access there at your local UCKG, you'll see also there are some locations. We have our bookshop there. We have them available at church, but online at christianbooks-plus.com.
This is it. This is my meditation Bible, Pastor Daniel.
Yes, mine as well, Bishop.
Right?
It has become, yes.
And we have told people to use this Bible here, because this Bible contains vital information that helps us to understand the context better. They give us an overview of so many things that if we went to a Bible that didn't have, you know, like footnotes or let's say the titles of the passage, we wouldn't be able to extract the most. Yes, I'm not saying that we cannot. Yes, we can. But these add-ons here, these are vital add-ons.
It's true.
This Bible is full of add-ons that help us to add on to our faith important components, right?
Yes, Bishop. We could definitely say that this Bishop is a study Bible. It helps with the commentaries. And we're going to see with the points that we're going to read in a few moments that this Bible
and
definitely...
And we have selected five points here, five tips.
And these points that we're going to read, we're going to see that this, the Bishop's Bible, the commentary of Bishop Macedo, it helps, it supports in all these, you know, these points we're going to read today. It gives support as far as giving more information that's not there. And definitely those who have their own Bible will see. Sometimes they have questions. What does this mean? Where was this? And the commentaries here of Bishop Macedo definitely help with that.
Definitely. This is it. Let's see what God told Joshua to do and what he tells you and me to do today. And by the way, you were feeling down, sad, weak, worn out, lukewarm. I am sure you are not eating. Yes, you are not feeding your spirit. Certainly, Pastor Daniel. I am absolutely certain many of those who are now feeling down, weak, empty, sad, they even say, my goodness, I am no longer the same. I'm not how I used to be. And that's because you are not feeding yourself from this bread here. Yes, from the Word of God, what gives us life. The Bible says the Word of God is life, life. So when we meditate on the Word, we receive more than just information, Pastor Daniel. We receive life, power. It's powerful. When we meditate on the Word, it stirs you up inside, isn't it? It's,
for sure.
It provokes a reaction in us. Does it happen to you?
It happens to me.
Yeah, it lifts us up. It's empowers us, renews us, revives us. It does so much for us.
Yes, Bishop, because in that moment that we open the Bible, we hear God's voice. He's speaking to us, and it's impossible that he speaks to us and we remain the same. So
never.
For sure, those who feel weak, who are discouraged, are down, we can be sure that their Bibles are closed.
Yes, so now look, let's open it.
Let's open the Bible.
Open your Bibles there in Joshua 1, verse 8. God said here to Joshua, and he's telling you and me today as well, this book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate in it day and night. Look how strong, Pastor Daniel. Not only once a week, this day and night, we understand it's as often as you can.
Yes.
Right? It's every day and not just when it's convenient, let's say once a day. No, it's
sometimes more than once a day.
It's true. This is it.
Day and night.
Day and night, that you may observe to do according to all. Look at the word all there. All that is written in it. Some people, Pastor Daniel, they don't do all. You know what people? Some people do. They pick up some verses that they know that's God's will for them. But they know that it's God's will, and they make sure that that is also according to their own will. It doesn't contradict their will. So they say, these ones I'm going to do. The other ones that contradict their will, it is still God's will.
Right.
But when they see that it goes against their will, they say, I think these verses are, you know, ancient. I think it's from, you know, especially the ones from the Old Testament. I think it's from... I believe it's for the Jews. I'm not a Jew. What a
lame excuse.
Come on, Pastor Daniel, isn't it?
Yes, Bishop, because it's it's very convenient for sometimes for people to get, you know, what's convenient for them.
Yeah.
What speaks blessings and rewards and all the things, the great things that God has promised. But then they leave out, they want to almost, you know, skip the page where they see things that they have require from them.
And you know, some people, they read half of the chapter.
Yeah.
Sometimes they read, you know, up until one verse, because they know the next one will prompt them to act, to leave some things behind, to sacrifice.
Yes.
And some people have the courage, the audacity to say, God didn't yet touch me. That's why I didn't sacrifice yet. God did not yet convince me. What a lame excuse again, Pastor Daniel.
Definitely, definitely, Bishop. No, and it's interesting because sometimes people, when they're reading the Word of God, they think this, the hard things,
yeah,
it's good for other people, right? Yeah. They say, oh, this message is
powerful.
They even
powerful. Say, look, I wish my husband was here.
Exactly.
To hear this message.
Yeah, always thinking of someone else, but not realizing God is speaking to them.
Yeah.
And they skip it. They just want to get the motivational verses for them. Some people use the Bible just for motivation. Oh, I like this scripture. It helps me feel good. But the book of the Word of God is not just about you feeling good, hearing what you want. There's plenty of there that we hear what we need.
Exactly.
In order to change our life.
And we have to put into practice.
Yes.
And we're going to find out more about these tips on how to meditate. I'm sure that this is going to help many of you, you who want to extract the best out of your Bible meditation, you who want to grow spiritually, to get strong, mature, get closer to God. You want to finish your race, you have to eat. Is it true or not?
Yes.
And come on, in the desert, you have to eat, you have to drink. This is food and drink, isn't it?
Yes. It's food and drink.
This is the food that will keep you going in the midst of the desert. There is no water in this desert. Yes. Don't think that there is a shop, an off license on this desert. No, 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 no. If there is, it's from the devil.
That's right.
It's the devil selling his water on the way. But remember, this is the fountain that where, you know, this is the fountain, the well, where you have to extract the water from every day so you can finish your race. So let's see what God said to Joshua, what he's telling us today. Joshua, chapter 1, verse 8. Again, don't forget to read the whole chapter 1, please. All right? Homework for you. Pastor Daniel, can you read for them there, please? Joshua chapter 1, verse 8.
This book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate in it day and night, that you may observe to do according to all that is written in it.
That's it. See,
for then,
read this and reading again. Let's go.
For then you will make your way prosperous, and then you will have good success.
Look at that. This is it. For people who are saying, I want success.
I want success.
I want to be prosperous. I want to be happy. What else do you need to hear? You who are even asking God, what else do I do? God's saying to you, meditate on these words. And of course, meditate and practice, right? These words. As God speaks, take action upon it. Well, I'm already giving them the tips. Let's go there,
yes.
Pastor Daniel. I always do that. Always go.
It's a
keep going forward and
let
me go back again. So let's go to the tips. Yes, before we seek the Holy Spirit, this is going to help you all a lot on how to meditate on the Word of God. So we have separated five tips there.
Yes.
5 points. Of course, there are many other things for us to mention, Pastor Daniel.
For sure.
But we're not going to be talking about everything here. We took what we believe is important, what will help you on your Bible meditation. So let's go for the first one there, Pastor Daniel, if I can count on your help there.
Yes, Bishop.
You can read for them there, the first tip there, first slide.
The first tip is find a quiet place. Meditating on the Bible is a great way to connect with God. So make sure you find a quiet place to read without any distractions.
Mm-hmm.
By doing this, you will be able to focus your mind on hearing and understanding the voice of God.
And therefore, we advise you to meditate on a Bible like this one here and not like this one here. Yes? On my phone. Do you have on your phone as well?
Huh? I have, yes. Sir.
I have a Bible on my phone. You do. The majority of us have. But remember, I'm not saying that it's a problem, right? Right? God's not going to speak to you because you're reading the Bible on the phone.
Right.
He will. But the problem is, what about the messages? What about the distractions? Huh?
Phone calls.
People
right?
call you. Ah, okay, no, I'm going to put everything on silent. And but as we know,
Pastor Daniel, all kinds of distractions,
it's always preferable to have a Bible like this, and especially this one here, where you know a Bible that you know will not have notifications on it, right?
For sure.
And you're going to be able to meditate on it peacefully, in a quiet place. Let's go to the next one there.
Always pray beforehand.
Very important, sir.
Before meditating on any Bible verse, you should always make a prayer, asking God to speak to you through the Bible verse or chapter that you will read. It is His word after all, so who better to guide you through it and help you gain a better understanding than God Himself?
And I'm going to add something here very important, Pastor Daniel. There comes the importance of having the Holy Spirit, because He is the one who guides us. He is the one who makes us understand. He guides us to all truth. Again, I want to say this to you. Make it a priority. The baptism in the Holy Spirit. You who have not been baptized, don't forget this is a must. This is your main priority. We are entering to a new month, and you can even say, oh, this month I'm going to dedicate more of my time on seeking the Holy Spirit, pleasing God, doing what I should have done before. Now I'm going to do it. He's going to honor you. You need Him. Especially when we read the Bible, Pastor Daniel, we meditate, He gives us the clues, the guidance, the understanding, right?
Yes.
He helps us. So make sure you focus on the baptism in the Holy Spirit. We're going to be seeking the Holy Spirit in a few moments, and in Jesus' name, many of you will be baptized today. Third one there.
When reading, ask yourself the five W's. Who, what, when, where, and why. Who is speaking here?
Mm-hmm.
Is it God, man, the devil?
Yeah, let's stop here for a moment. For you who didn't know, in this book called the Holy Bible, we have the Word of God, the Word of man, and the Word of the devil. That's right. The three of them spoke here. It has been registered. And careful with this kind of funny way, isn't it, Pastor Daniel, of picking a passage or saying, Lord, speak to me.
Yeah.
Speak to me. And people do like this. And they do like this.
A random verse. Yeah.
Imagine if your finger lands on the word of the devil.
That's right.
And that's what many people have been doing. They read the word there, and it's the devil speaking or man. It's man speaking. And imagine you base your life upon the word of the devil or the word of man. You're going to wreck your life. That's why many lives are not progressing. And I know of people who started churches basing everything on the word of the devil, on the word of man, Pastor Daniel.
That's right, Bishop.
Imagine.
Yeah, no, it's lack of intelligence, you know, when a person reads something randomly without knowing the full content, who's speaking here,
you know,
what is being said. We need to know what comes even before the verse we're reading, what comes after, the whole context.
The whole context, very, very important. Don't do this. Yes, of course, you're going to be able to meditate on a particular verse. You know, the one that you stop there and you said, okay, important, what I have just read here. But don't just pick a verse and say, I'm going to base my life upon this. Find out who is talking there.
Mm-hmm.
Find out what verses are before and after. Sometimes you're going to have to go to other passages to understand better. And the next one there, Pastor, then let's go to the slide again.
So it asks here, what, right? What does this passage mean? What is it about? What significant words are repeated? They are probably important.
Yes, for sure they are.
When did this happen?
Very important, isn't it? When, we have to ask.
Next, why did this happen?
Mm-hmm.
Where did this take place? Or where can I find other verses in reference to this passage?
Mm-hmm.
Look up the meaning of any words you do not know. Is there anything in the verse you need to obey? If so, decide immediately what action you are going to take.
Yes, this is very, very important. Huh? The moment you ask this question, is there anything in this verse you need to obey? I need to obey? As we read there, if so, decide immediately what action you are going to take. We're going to go for a quick break now. We're giving you tips on how to meditate on the Word of God. Important tips, directions, and I'm sure as you apply it on your life, you will benefit from your Bible meditation. You're going to bless your life. Let's go for this quick break. We still have two more tips to give to you, and we're going to be seeking the Holy Spirit together.
Be inspired on Liberty Radio.
A follower waits to be given bread and fish. A disciple is a fisherman. A follower strives to grow. A disciple strives to make other disciples. A follower surrenders some of himself. A disciple surrenders his entire life. A follower likes to be praised. A disciple likes to serve and sacrifice. A follower adds, but a disciple multiplies. A follower is controlled by his circumstances. A disciple uses his faith to overcome them. A follower is valuable, while a disciple is indispensable. The Universal Church of the Kingdom of God. Find practical faith for life.
Be inspired on Liberty Radio.
Welcome back to Be Inspired. In a few moments, we're going to be seeking the Holy Spirit together, and we are giving you tips on how to meditate on the Word of God. We separated five important tips. We already gave you three. Just recapping the first one there, find a quiet place. Second, always pray beforehand. Third one, when reading, ask yourself the five W's: who, what, when, where, and why. And now, Pastor Daniel, let's go for the fourth one.
The fourth one says, make notes and highlight what is important. Mm-hmm. Feel free to make a note of what God has spoken to you in the reading session. Writing things down can help you broaden your understanding of the verse. Mm-hmm. Do not hesitate to underline, write in the margins, or circle words that are important to you.
Right. And the last one?
Think about how you will apply God's word to your life and act.
This is very important. Let's go on.
When meditating on the word of God, you should seek to understand how what you have read applies to your day-to-day life and put it into practice. By doing this, you will be able to get the most out of your meditation. Think of it this way. The Word of God is like a seed. Unless you plant it, act upon what it says, it will not be able to spring forth and bear fruit in your life.
Can you see? Many people know what they have to do, understand it, but they do not practice. God speaks to them. God says, do this. Don't do that. Stop doing this or start doing that. And if people do not take action upon it, Pastor Daniel, number one, they're not going to see results in their lives. And when it comes to repentance, because sometimes the Holy Spirit speaks to us saying, you have to correct yourself. You have to forgive. You have to let go of this grudge. You have to abandon this sinful habit. And if people don't listen to the voice of the Holy Spirit, this is it, Pastor Daniel.
Yeah.
If there is no repentance, imagine, there will be no forgiveness. And no forgiveness means no condemnation, no salvation.
That's right, Bishop. And I was thinking now as you're speaking, Bishop, I was thinking about what is the reaction of a person when we talk to someone and we talk to that person and we talk and we say the same thing over and over and over again.
That's right.
And we don't see any action. We don't see any reaction. Our tendency is to not speak anymore. We say, you know what, this person is not listening to me.
Because why should I? I have spoken more than 10 times and the person is giving me the deaf ear, right? Even though I care for that person, I love that person, but she is not listening. He's not listening.
That's right. And I think this is what happens when people, they're just reading the Bible just to read. So they say, oh, God didn't speak to me. It's because sometimes they're getting just information.
Yeah.
But when God sees that the person, okay, I'm going to read, I'm going to meditate on the word because I want to know what do I have to do. And they start applying what they do. God sees this. And eventually, of course, God keeps speaking to them and the word of God bears fruit in their life.
That's right. When we meditate on the word, we have to do it with an open heart, not trying to select what is convenient to us, what pleases us. We have to be ready to read and even say to God, Lord, here I am, ready to obey, ready to do whatever you ask me to do. Isn't it?
That's
otherwise,
right.
How can God work in one's life? That's how can God manifest his power the way he wants in a person's life?
That's right, Bishop. We have to show God that moment, the willingness, you know, whatever he's telling me to do, I'm going to apply it. I'm going to put it into action. And without this, if we don't put it into action, then it's just going to be information, words that you receive. And like it says here, it will be seeds, but if you don't plant it, so it's not going to bear fruit. The opposite happens when we listen, when we hear God,
yes,
and we decide, we have a, you know, a ready to act, ready to do what God is telling us, we're going to see fruit out of this word.
And right now, before we seek the Holy Spirit, we are going to play a song in preparation for this moment. You will have a look on your heart, and you know what I mean. Having a look on your heart, spiritually speaking, are you going to see how is the state of your heart? Check it out. See if there is no grudge there, or hard feeling, or wrong intention, malice. Is there any seed of pride, Pastor Daniel? Vanity, isn't it? Attachments to the world. Is there any idol there in your heart? No, I don't bow down to pieces of wood and stone. An idol can be a person. Whoever you put above God, whatever you put above God, whatever you revere, you make that the center of your life. That's your idol. That becomes your idol. Yes, I can be an idolater, Pastor Daniel, and I don't bow down to pieces of silver and stone. I don't bow down to statues.
True.
But see, if my job, my career is above God, that means I'm putting it above God. That means I am not spending time with God because I'm too busy with that. Imagine, that's my idol. And this goes for family as well. When do we put family above God, Pastor Daniel? I was thinking about this. Some people say, I don't put my family above God. When your family, because of traditions, because you don't want to displease them, you do what they say, you do what they do, and you know that you're displeasing God. That's how we put them above God.
It's true, Bishop.
How do I put my husband or my wife above God? When I do something that pleases him, pleases her, but displeases God, I'm putting them above God.
Yes, Bishop. The moment that I'm worrying about what they're going to think, what are they going to say, I'm worried more about being well with them.
Yeah.
So automatically, this means we're trading. We're trading places. God, instead of him being first, now my number one concern has become my family, someone else.
That's right.
So this means this becomes my God.
Imagine, Pastor Daniel, Sunday, the day of the Lord, how many people they can be in the house of God, but they say, no, it's family time. We are not against you spending time with your family. The problem is when spending time with your family gives you no time for God. That's the problem. And Sunday is the day of the Lord. Everything comes next on Sunday, especially Sunday morning, Pastor Daniel. There is no other place more important than the house of God for a person to be at, right? Because
That's
it's
right.
the day of the Lord.
Right.
I'm not going to be in my father's, in my friend's house.
No.
Or in a place that is not the house of the Lord.
That's right.
And how many people are not being blessed because they are not prioritizing their Sunday. Imagine, they are attending the service on the day of the Lord. And I'll even go further, Pastor Daniel. I don't know if some people are going to be upset with me now.
But I think they need it.
You know, I have to talk, Pastor Daniel.
That's right.
I'm going to say it.
We have to say it.
There are people who come, but they come late.
Yes.
Come late. No respect, reverence.
Yeah.
And they think that it's okay. Coming late to the service, there's a total lack of respect for God.
That's right.
And people start wondering, they start saying, I'm not living in sin. Oh my goodness, my prayers are not being answered. I love God. I respect him. Do you really do? Are you really practicing all the things that are appointed for you to practice? God doesn't make a big deal out of somebody coming late to the service. Hello. He does. Oh, yes, he does. God pays attention to details, Pastor Daniel.
Definitely.
God sees when we present offerings and our hearts are dirty. God sees when we present our tithes and even sacrifices, but we have grudges against people. God sees certain things that nobody does. And he notices that. God is a God of detail. Don't forget that. He pays attention to details. You can be doing something for him. Yes, he sees you doing. But not only that, he sees how you are doing it. What is the intention of you doing that?
That's right, Bishop. I mean, if for a man, we would be more than, you know, we're more than understanding, you know, when a person says you have to be here on time, the doctor expects you to be there on time, you won't be late for your solicitor, you won't be late for your boss, because you won't be late for a court, you know, appearance, because you know I can't displease this person.
Imagine an appointment at Buckingham Palace.
That's right. I can't tell the person, oh, I'm sorry, I'm late because of this and that. You understand.
Yeah.
No, the person will do everything to be there early. They arrive an hour early.
That's right.
They know they can't miss the appointment. It's no nonsense. So why would I do the same for my God, the God of my salvation? No, for him, I have to do my very
best.
That's right. If he's first, so then we have to show it with action, not with words.
So during this break, humble yourself there. Ask Jesus to have mercy on you, to forgive you. You can even say, sorry, Lord, for thinking that you are not paying attention to certain things that I don't pay attention to, but he does. God wants you to be happy, to be blessed. But there are certain things in your life right now that are impeding him from doing his work in your life. He is a potter. And when the potter, Pastor Daniel, shapes the clay, we even put there during the break, the potter shaping the clay there. You're going to see the image there. He does it according to his will. He knows what is the best, right, way to shape it. And if he encounters a dirtiness there, let's say a piece of wood there or a little piece of rock, he has to stop everything. And as long as that dirtiness remains there, he cannot shape and mold that vessel. So he has to stop and then removes the dirtiness, and then he starts again the process of shaping that piece of clay. How many people, maybe you who are listening to us now, you don't see God shaping you, molding you, or working in your life. It's like his hands stopped working. And here goes the answer. There might be there dirtiness. And he wants to remove, but he does it with your permission. You have to say, take it from me now, Lord. So do it during this break. Ask Jesus to forgive you. Tell him to wash away all the impurities, whatever it is that is impeding him from doing a great work in you and in your life. Don't wait any longer. Humble yourself. Surrender your life to him. Stop resisting his voice. Enough of suffering. Enough of pain. We'll be right back.
Be Inspired on Liberty Radio.
Come, Holy Spirit, to touch me, to hold me, to be in your presence is everything I need. The truest friend to me, I raise my hands to worship you, to surrender all my heart to you, as broken as I am. As wretched as I am, you love me, you love me. Jesus, in your love, you died on the cross for me. The burden of my sins you took away. You healed my pain and gave me life. Jesus, in your love, you died on the cross for me. The burden of my sins you took away. You healed my pain and gave me life. Jesus.
Inspired on Liberty Radio.
So let us now invest in our communion with God. Let's seek the Holy Spirit. You who have just said to God, Lord, cleanse me, wash away the impurities from my life, my sins. You can be sure He heard your voice. He has just cleansed you. And you who have just connected, you can do this now. As we said before the break, you saw there the potter working, shaping, molding that piece of clay, turning a formless piece of clay into a marvelous piece of art, a jar. And it's all for His glory. Yes, the jar glorifies the one who made it. Is it true or not? The piece of art, the masterpiece, glorifies its maker. That's what God wants to do in your life, in my life. He wants to shape us, mold us, to turn us into a beautiful vase, a masterpiece, so everyone may say that He is great. It's nothing about us. It's all about Him. So humble yourself with us there. If you haven't done this yet, repent, confess your sins, abandon all these impurities that are impeding the hands of the potter from doing a great work in your life. Remember what we said before the break. As long as there is impurity in the clay, the hands of the potter will be unable to work on it. First, he has to remove the impurity, and then he starts the whole process. You saw there, Pastor Danny, we see how the clay, see, has to be moving, right?
Definitely.
See, the platform there has to be rotating, right? And then the hands will start working as well.
Shaping
and doing whatever needs to be done for the good of that clay. But when there is impurity, the platform stops, the hands stop, and he has now to remove the dirtiness. And as we said, if we don't let the potter remove the impurity, the work's going to be stuck there, right? There'll be no more work. And that's the sad reality of some people who have not yet confessed their sins, abandoned their impurities, their sins. Their lives are there, meaningless. Not because God wants it to be this way, but they have not yet allowed Him to remove the dirtiness and allowed Him to do His work in their life. Because when He starts doing the work, imagine some clay say, don't touch here, don't touch there.
Right.
How can He work in us like this?
Definitely. We can't say, God, mold me, shape me, and then say, but not like this, but not like that. No, God, shape me, mold me. What is it that I have to change? This?
Yeah.
Okay, Lord, so I'm willing to change. I'm willing to do what You're telling me.
That's right.
And when we ask God with this sincerity and with the willingness to take action immediately, so be sure, God, He will do, and He's going to make a masterpiece out of your life.
Correct. Let's humble ourselves now. Pastor Daniel, you can start praying with them there. Some people have just arrived. They didn't get a chance to humble themselves and confess their sins. You know, take away from them the impurities so God may save their souls, first of all, and work in their lives, turning them into a living proof of His power. As with this, you can do this part there, and I will seek the Holy Spirit with them straight after this one. Because if we don't pour out what is inside of us, if we don't let Him take away what is separating us from Him, how can we receive the living waters? How can we have communion with Him?
That's right, Bishop.
So let's humble ourselves now. Close your eyes if you can, and let's have our moment of intimacy with God. Close your eyes, please.
My God, in the name of Jesus, we are in Your presence right now.
Yes,
and this
Lord.
Person that humbles themselves in this moment, wanting to remove all the impurities, but they need Your help, Lord.
Yes.
And as they are sincere to acknowledge their sin, to acknowledge their mistake, the impurity that's been there in their hearts, maybe for years, for a long time. But this is the moment, my God. This is the moment they're asking You, who are the potter, to shape them, to mold them, but to also remove this impurity, my God. So help this person now, my God, that decides to remove this grudge, to remove this pride, the vanity, whatever this person had been inclining themselves, leaning towards the pleasures of this world, my Lord. But right now that they make a decision to stop, a decision, Lord, to turn their lives around, so may you come upon them to forgive them, that you may bear inside of them, Lord, let there be now this forgiveness. Yes, my God, the gift of forgiveness may come upon them to truly repent, to truly abandon their old life and to despise, to hate the sin that they had lived in for so long. So right now, receive now the strength, the assurance, yes, the certainty that this moment it would be different because you repent of your sin. You repent of your past life. So receive now this forgiveness in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Wherever you are repenting, he washes away your sins, all the iniquities, impurities. Be free right now. Yes, stand up where you are now. Please lift up your face. Lift up your hands. Receive salvation. Yes, be free from your doubts, accusations. And now with certainty, with the assurance that there is nothing that can separate you from God, ask Jesus to fill you with his Spirit. Go ahead, say, Lord, baptize me with your Holy Spirit. Renew me, revive me. Go ahead, it's you and him now. Receive the Holy Spirit now, wherever you are. Be baptized in the Holy Spirit. Be filled with the plenitude of God. He fills you with his power now. Rejoice. He is there with you. He has the assurance now. Is the sign, is the confirmation there that he is with you. This is it. You who have been saying, I'm seeking a confirmation, I'm asking, you don't need that. He now comes and says, I am with you. Be filled with his presence there now. Yes, he touches your life. He is there with you. You can adore him now. Praise him. Worship him. Continue giving more of yourself, and he will give you more of himself now. Thank you, Father, for blessing us. I'm sure many are now experiencing you there, being renewed, revived. And continue helping us, my Lord, to practice the direction you gave Joshua and you gave us, to meditate on your words day and night, night and day, so we may be prosperous in our way and may be successful in everything we do. Protect us, guard us, deliver us from all evil, my Lord. We surrender the lives of those who are connected with us here now in your hands, and we determine their lives to glorify you. Bless their families, their finances, their health. Bring your success into all the areas of their lives now, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Let's go in this faith, huh? Meditate on the word. Give me the Bible here, Pastor Daniel, please. Continue making sure that every day you are meditating on the word of God. We're going to be doing this every day. Also, and don't forget, every Wednesday in church and here on the radio, we're going to be extracting vital lessons and we're going to give it to you. So once you apply it in your life, certainly you see great results. Before we let you go, just letting you know that this coming Friday, Pastor Daniel, it's going to be a powerful Friday. We're going to be turning curses into blessings.
That's right.
Right? We're going to be turning curses into blessings. That's what the Word of God says. God turns a curse into a blessing. As they can see there, the slide, this coming Friday, especially 7:30 p.m., but also throughout the day.
That's right, Bishop. God wants to change this person's life from curse to blessing, from death to life, from darkness into light. God wants to take what has been in your life, yes, you know, stuck until now, and help you break through. So this Friday, come prepared, come determined to turn around your situation from curse to blessing.
That's right. Wherever you are, you who are there desperate, you don't know what else to do. Maybe your life now is dry, meaningless, fruitless. You have been feeling down, sad, depressed, suicidal. God is talking to you now. Look at this. This is your answer. He's using us to say to you, there is hope for you. You can also experience what we did. So this coming Friday, especially in the evening, we're going to be in Finsbury Park and in all the UCKGs across the United Kingdom. If you need to know more about addresses, go to uckg.org/addresses for you to know more about all the addresses in the United Kingdom. And this Sunday is going to be very strong as well, Pastor Daniel. Sunday, we're going to be blessing all the tithers.
That's right.
And also, we're going to be anointing their bread with the oil that we are consecrating throughout the week. Have a look on the oil there, Pastor Daniel. For sure, God is going to provide to His people. This month of October is going to be a month of great provision.
That's right, Bishop. Just like God would not allow for there to be lack of bread, lack, yes, of anything for Israel. And every day He prepared for their daily needs. Mm-hmm. So in this month of October, this is what we are determined, that as the faithful, we are faithful to God.
Yes.
He is faithful to provide.
That's,
and it,
right,
will be a month of breakthrough, Bishop.
As you can see the bottle there, we are consecrating the oil. And this Sunday, arrive earlier to the service, especially. Today we spoke about this, huh?
Yes.
Let's see who is going to practice, huh?
That's right.
This coming Sunday. So from 9:30 until 10 a.m., we're going to be putting a drop from that oil that we are consecrating every single day this week on the loaf of bread that you are going to bring. You can bring water and a loaf of bread. At the doors of the sanctuary, we're going to be putting a drop there, consecrating your bread, what will symbolize the manna, the provision of God to your life as you eat with your family. You can be sure, not only physically, but also spiritually, God is going to bless you all greatly. He will provide to you and to your family members. This coming Sunday, 10 a.m., the most important service of the day. We also have services in the morning and also in the afternoon, earlier, 7:30 a.m. Right, Pastor Daniel?
Yes.
So if you cannot come at 10, you can join us at 7:30 a.m. We're going to let you go now. Have a wonderful day, afternoon, or evening, wherever you are. And let's continue practicing the Word of God. See you tomorrow at 10 p.m. once again. And don't forget, in church, we have our love therapy at 8 p.m. You can come with your husband, your wife, and you who are single as well. You can join us here, especially in Finsbury Park at 8 p.m. Bye-bye.
Come, Holy Spirit, to touch me, to hold me, to be in your presence is everything I need, the truest friend to me. I raise my hand to worship you, to surrender all my heart to you, as broken as I am. You love me, you love me, as wretched as I am. Died on the cross for me, the burden of my sins you took away, you healed my pain and gave me life, Jesus. your love, you died on the cross for me. The burden of my sins you took away. You healed my pain and gave me life. Jesus, Jesus, what a precious name.
Liberty Radio.